I look at the history of Indian painting, particularly Mughal, and to a lesser extent, Rajput and Deccani painting. And the other strand of my work, I look at museums. I look at the history, the politics, and the place that museums have played in the very formation of the history of art. In the case of my work on museums, to a large extent, it's based on textual sources, whether I'm looking at books that have been written previously, or I'm looking at sources in the archives of many different kinds. But there's also a component of ethnography in there, where one speaks to not just the visitors of the museums, but one can also do an ethnography of those who make museums, those who collect art, which eventually finds its way into these repositories. So that's one set of methods that I use. For the study of painting, we look at textual sources, we try and understand social and economic history. But what is particular to art history also is the way in which we are attuned to the formal qualities of a work of art, and the way in which one has to produce, I think, a data bank in one's head of images so that one, when one sees a new image, one is able to relate it to maybe images that one had seen 20 years previously and realize that there must have been a connection between them. It's not just the making of art that is politically situated, but even, and quite particularly I would say, our understanding of art, our choices about what we preserve, our choices about what we choose to write about and tell people are the major masterpieces of the time. These are all choices that are political in the sense that they are an exercise of power of a particular kind. But of course, there's a very important set of politics that operates around the site of the production of the work of art. This always has to be in a field that is full of inequalities, and therefore it is inherently political. Museums came to India as a colonial institution, and once the colonial period was over, museums remained in India and they took on a different kind of role. They started showcasing different kinds of objects that would testify to the deep history of India, how extensive its civilization had been, and what kind of heights had been attained by its artists. So the museums got redefined by a certain nationalist purpose, which was to shore up the pride that Indians could take in the culture that had flourished in this land over so many centuries. Among the humanities, art history is actually a very young discipline. And in many ways, art history is actually connected to a history of photography. And yet, because of the kinds of things that art history deals with, it has become recognized that art history is an important factor or an important component of the humanities, no less than philosophy. It would help us to understand the interlinkages, the relationships, the concurrences that are necessary for a civilization to flourish. So I would say that for a place like India, actually art history is not just a necessity, but it's actually an urgent necessity. There are many aspects of my work which are very enriching and very fulfilling. But for me, I think the most intensely satisfying part of my professional life is the process of writing something. It's a process actually of struggle, where you start with troubling questions. But when you actually find some sort of resolution or you get an insight, it's fantastic. So one of the things that I would really like to, in some way, give a push to would be a project of translation of some of the most important art historical and art critical work in English or perhaps in French or German, but into other Indian languages like Hindi. For my PhD, I chose to work on some folk painting traditions. And after I did that study, I suddenly realized that when we keep telling ourselves that in the village we see that artwork in context, in a museum we see it as decontextualized. I realized how stupidly wrong that was, because a museum is not a lack of context, it is another context. And it is our context for our encounter with works of art. And that, I think, was my aha moment. And that got me started in the study of museums. The first, second, third, and fourth quality have to be persistence. But a quality that we don't usually acknowledge sufficiently in research is actually the importance of imagination. So a researcher who has imagination, who has a sense of play in their work, ask questions which are not only the good questions to ask, but which hadn't occurred to anybody until then, that were questions to ask. And that is an incredibly important quality to have. I already had a good sense of how prestigious the Infosys Prize is, and never in a thousand years did I ever imagine that such a thing would come to me. And when I first heard about it, my reaction was utter disbelief. And I still find it a bit unreal that this has happened.